Welcome children. Today chapter 8 quadrilaterals we are going to see. So in that exercise 8.1 already you have seen first three problems of that exercise, and now we are going to see question number 4. For this you should know what is the square and the properties of square. And you know the square means all sides equal, and to tell about the angles, each angle is measure 90 degree, and the diagonals are equal and they bisect at right angle. And now this question, that concept you have to use here, and also the lines and angles concept, congruence triangle property concept. Using these we can easily prove this sum. You see here, show that the diagonals of a square are equal and bisect each other at right angles. That means, you see here ABCD you take as a square, and diagonals are AC and BD whose measure are equal and they bisect at O. Now we have to show that in this square the diagonals are equal in length, that you know already about the properties you know, but here they are asking to show the diagonals of this square are equal and also they bisect at right angle. So we have to show that. Okay. So, given ABCD is a square, to prove diagonal AC is equal to diagonal BD. So, that is the first option. And the second one, AC and BD, that the diagonals bisect at right angle. So, this is what we have to prove. And in the proof part, the first option, you have to show the diagonals are equal in length. For that, we are going to take the two triangles. You see what I am taking here. You consider the triangle BAD. You see, just I am splitting for your better understanding. For example, A, this is B, BAD triangle, and another triangle, this one. Okay. So ABC. So BAD or ABC. These are the two triangles we are going to take, and we are going to try to say these two triangles are congruent. After saying that they are congruent, easily we can say by CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangle, we can easily say that this AC and BD are equal, because by CPCT. Okay, so this is what we are going to do here. The first one, I am taking that these two triangles, in triangle BAD and triangle ABC. In these two triangles, we are going to say they are congruent. For that, we have to collect any three corresponding parts are equal. You see, it's AB. This AB is common of both triangles. So, AB equal to AB. This is common. Common side. And the next, you know that in square, that the sides are equal. So, that the diagonals of a square. So, it is a square. ABCD. So, you can have that these two sides equal. So, AD equal to BC. Equal to BC. And you see the angle, you know these two angles are 90 degree, because each angle of a square is 90 degree. So, we can have that was the first triangle. We can have BAD angle is equal to their ABC angle, both are 90 degree. This angle of a square is 90 each angle. So, you can take that. So, two pair of sides and one pair of angle. So, SAS property, we can say triangle BAD congruent to triangle ABC. This is by SAS congruence. Easily we can say these two triangles are congruent. And now, after saying congruent, by CPCT we can easily say from this triangle BD is equal to and AC. Okay? CPCT, we can say they are equal. This is nothing but they are the diagonals of the square. So, diagonals AC and BD are equal. And now we are going to prove that option 2. You see here, option 2. So AC and BD bisect at right angle. So the two diagonals are equal. We have proved that. So next, AC and BD, the two diagonals bisect at right angle. So first we let us prove they bisect each other. So further, you see, bisect means what? Suppose one diagonal AC is bisect other diagonal, means so both are bisecting each other. So we have to show that O will act as the midpoint of both diagonals. That means OA, OC equal, OB, OD equal. So like that, if you show, then easily you can say the diagonals bisect each other. So for that, we are going to take the two triangles AOD, BOC. So in triangle AOD and BOC. So why I am choosing these two triangles? These two triangles. You know why? Here only we can have OA, OC and OB, OD, everything. So we are choosing that AOD triangle and BOC triangle. And now in these two triangles, so easily we can say that AD and BC are equal because sides of square are equal. So we can easily say that AD from this triangle and BC from this triangle are equal. So equal sides of square. This is the reason, equal sides of square. And then you see this angle 1 of this triangle and angle 2, let it be 2. So this is 1 and let it be 2. So angle 1 and angle 2 are equal. You know why? Alternate interior angles. How we can say that they are alternate interior angles? Angle 1 is equal to angle 2. So alternate angles. Okay, alternate angles. Because since ABCD is a square, we can say these two are AD and BC parallel, and you take BD as transversal. You see, often you don't need to write that. If you say the reason alternate angles, that's enough. But I'm explaining you, you see. So like this. Okay, this is A, D one line and B, C. You consider they are the two lines, AD and BC. And you see, this is the transversal. BD is the transversal. Then easily we can have angle 1 and this angle 2 are the Z angle. So they are equal. So nothing but they are alternate interior angles. So by using that lines and angles property, here we are going to say that angle 1 is equal to angle 2. In the same way, you can say from this triangle, you can have this is 3 and this is 4. So these two are also alternate interior angles when you take AC as the transversal. Okay, so angle 3 is equal to angle 4. The same reason, alternate angles. So two pair of angles and one pair of sides are equal. So by what through congruence rule we can say the two triangles are congruent. So ASA, okay, two angles and one side, so the included side. Okay, you can say this implies triangle AOD congruent to triangle BOC. By what rule? ASA rule. ASA congruence rule. They are, the two triangles are congruent. After saying that they are congruent, by using the CPCT, we can have that from this triangle OA, this implies OA equal to their OC. OC, the reason by CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. And again, here OD, the first triangle we have taken AOD, so here OD. OD is equal to the next triangle OB. So OB, OB, they are equal. This is also CPCT, the reason. So now we have proved that this segment and these two segments are equal. Therefore, what? O will act as the midpoint of the two diagonals. So, we can easily say the diagonals bisect each other. So, the diagonals AC and BD bisect each other. Okay, through this we can say easily that they bisect each other. And one more thing, they bisect at right angle. That means what? You have to say the angle between the diagonal is 90 degree. So everywhere here around the point O, the angle is 90 degree. 90, 90, 90, 90. So the four angles around the point O. So that four angles are each 90 means. Then we can easily say that the two diagonals bisect at right angle. They are perpendicular. Like that we can say. So for that we are going to try to say that. So you take these two triangles. You know why? If you take these two, then we can say these two angles. If you try to say they are equal, you see what happened now. Now itself we can say, after saying these two are equal, these two angles are vertically opposite angles equal, and these two angles are vertically opposite angle. You know, angle 1, 2, vertically opposite angle, and angle 3, angle 4. 3 and 4 are vertically opposite angle and they are equal. 1 and 2 equal, 3 and 4 equal, because when two lines intersect, vertically opposite angles are equal, that you know. So by that idea also you can take that. But that is not the matter here. You have to say the adjacent angles, for example, this and this angles are equal, like that you have to say. Then only we can get all angles are equal around the point O. All the four angles are equal. So, you have to take in triangle AOB and triangle BOC. You see, OB is common, right? First of all, you take what are the things equal. OB, OB, both triangle, you can say the common sides. And another thing, from here OA and there OC. OA, OC equal, proved, already proved. Above, we have proved it. This OA is equal to OC. And the next one, AB and BC are equal. AB is equal to BC because equal sides of square. That you know. Okay. So, three pairs of sides equal. So, triangle AOB congruent to triangle BOC. The reason, triplet congruence rule. Okay. By triplet congruence rule, we can say these two triangles are congruent. After saying they are congruent, we can take AOB angle is equal to angle BOC. So, what letter I am reading, just follow that. AOB and BOC, these two angles are equal by CPCT, we can say. Okay. And you see how I am proceeding the sum. Now, after saying these two angles are equal, we know AOB and COD are equal. Angle AOB is equal to COD. Reason is BOA, in capital letter I am writing. Already you know what is expansion of BOA, that is vertically opposite angles, AOB and COD. So, BOC and AOD. And BOC is equal to AOD. This is also vertically opposite angle. Okay, that means what? AOB, BOC equal, but AOB is equal to COD, BO is equal to AOD. That means what? All the angles are equal. You see all the last three steps, AOB, BOC. So, AOB, BOC equal, therefore these two also equal. Left hand side equal means right hand side also become equal. Therefore, each angles are equal. This implies AOB equal to BOC equal to COD is equal to AOD. All the four angles around the point O become equal now. So after saying they are equal, by applying that sum of all the angles around a point plus BOC plus COD plus AOD is equal to 360 degree. So this is the reason how we are getting 360 means around a point the angle is 360, that you know. Okay, so if this is the point means, okay, this is the point. So around that point the angle is what? 360 degree. If you draw any ray around that point, the total angle is 360, that you know. First example, if the point is from that point, if three rays are going means, then angle, 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 three angles are there, they will form the 360 degree. Okay, if they add, you get 360. So here I am applying that. So around this point four angles are there, the sum of the four angles will be 360. And now after that you can have AOB, that is 4 angle AOB equal to 360 degree. You know why? So you can substitute for each angle the same AOB, okay, because they are equal. So 4 angle AOB equal to 360, therefore the angle AOB is equal to 90 degree. 360 by 4 you get 90 degree. So that means what? Each angle AOB 90 means all angles are around the point O 90 only. So this implies each angle around what? The point O is 90 degree. So we can say that diagonals are perpendicular to each other. So the diagonals are perpendicular to each other. So this symbol stands for perpendicular. So by combining these two, bisect each other, perpendicular to each other, so combine, we can say diagonals bisect at right angle. Hence diagonals AC and BD bisect at right angles. So this is the way we have to prove. Now question number 5, a converse of question number 4. In question number 4, it is given a square and you have to show the diagonals of the square are equal and they bisect at right angle. But in question number 5, the converse, you see, the question, in the question they have given a quadrilateral ABCD and we have to show that in that quadrilateral the diagonals are equal and bisect each other at right angle, then it is a square. Okay, suppose we take ABCD as a quadrilateral, you take a former, I will explain how to do that, some hint I will give. So you, by using that you do as homework. So you consider ABCD as a quadrilateral first, and in this quadrilateral they have given that diagonals are equal, that means what? AC equal to BD and they are bisect at right angle. That means what? They bisect means OA equal to OC, OB equal to OD, that and all you have. And we have to say, also they given that right angle, they bisect at right angle. So around the point O, all the angles are right angle. So like that they have given. And in this condition, that quadrilateral will be a square. So that is what you have to show. So to say this quadrilateral ABCD as a square, we need opposite, all sides are equal. First parallel and equal. Okay, we have to show ABCD are parallel and equal. In the same way, BC, AD are parallel and equal. And one more thing, each angle is 90 degree. For example, if you take angle A, it should be 90. So like that, all angles are 90. If you say this two, okay, first one is opposite sides. That means parallel and equal. That means all sides. And then we have to say all sides equal. Okay. So first you have to try to say AB, DC parallel and equal. And then AB equal to AD means then all sides should be equal. So like that you have to go and say. And now after coming to this point, each angle is 90 degree. If you say these two points, then that quadrilateral ABCD becomes a square. Okay, children. So you have to follow these two. You just try, it will be very easy. So I will explain you. First of all, I am taking this quadrilateral. Here, what are the things given? OA equal to OC, and then OB equal to OD. So everything they have given. Okay. And you see, the angles are also 90. Each angle of the point around O, each angle is 90. Okay. It is what given in the question. So first you take these two triangles. So in these two triangles, easily we can say they are congruent. Why we are choosing that two triangle? Then only we can say, after proving congruent, AB and CD are equal by CPCT. So you know how to say congruent, because you have this OA of this triangle and OC equal, OB equal to OD equal, that's what given there. And these two angles are also vertically opposite angle, they are equal. So that, like that, we can easily prove triangle AOB congruent to triangle COD. Easily you can say. So after proving congruent by CPCT, we can say AB, side AB equal to CD of this quadrilateral. And then we have to say AB and AD are equal. So for that, we have to take these two triangles, okay, to prove that congruent. So this triangle AOD and AOB, we have to prove that they are congruent. And then you can have AB and AD are equal by CPCT. So we can easily say all sides are equal. Okay. Similarly, we can say that. For that, you have to prove these two are congruent. You know how to say congruent? OA is the common side. In these two triangles, OA is the common side, and then OB, OD are equal, and then these two angles are 90 degree. They have given that. They bisect at right angle. Diagonals bisect at right angle they have given. So easily we can say these two triangles are congruent by applying a congruent rule. After that, AB side is equal to AD. Easily we can say. So AB equal to CD, the same AB equal to AD. So similarly we can say AB equal to AD equal to DC equal to DC, all sides equal, the same way. So after that, parallel also you have to say. Parallel means how to say that? You consider these two angles are equal. First this triangle, and you take this triangle. By CPCT we can say they two are equal. After saying that they are equal, they are alternate angles. Okay, any two lines. Okay, any two lines intersect by a transversal, then this and this angle are what? Alternate interior angle. In the same way, AB, CD, DC, you can say AB, DC or any two lines intersect by the transversal BD, it means then this angle and this angle will be equal. Or you can have this AC is a transversal, and angle 1 and 2 are alternate interior angle, and but they are alternate, so they are equal, and through this you can say AB is parallel to DC. So opposite sides are parallel and equal, and all sides are equal. So after saying these two triangles are congruent, we have AB equal to AD. So opposite sides are equal and parallel, all sides are also equal, therefore it becomes a square. The half of the part is over. To say it is square. And coming to angle, each angle of the square, you see, you have to say all the four angles are equal. You know how? For that, you have to take the two triangle like this. Considering the side AB, you can have the two triangle like this. You know, already I have explained you the previous sum. Like that, you have to take. Keeping the side AB, we have the two sides. This is D and this is C. So DAB is one triangle and ABC is another triangle. Okay, by keeping the side AB, we have two triangle, and we have to try to say these two are congruent. After saying congruent, these two angles are equal, like that you can see the angle 1 and 2. Okay, these two angles are equal by CPCT. So the same way, by keeping the side BC, you get another two triangle. Am I right? So BC, if you join, you say keeping BC as the side, you see BCD is one triangle, ABC is another triangle. So through that we can say this angle, full angle C and full angle B are equal. And by keeping CD as side, we can say this full angle, that means the triangle BCD and triangle CDA are equal by CPCT, sorry, congruent by CPCT, then this and this full angle equal. A similar way, okay, you can put similarly. If one, suppose angle 1 equal to angle 2, if you prove mean, proved means, then by similarly we can say angle 2 equal to angle 3, angle 3 equal to angle 4, angle 4 equal to angle 1, so like that you can say. So now we have proved all the angles of this quadrilateral equal. Then coming to the angle sum property of quadrilateral, adding all the four angles equal to 360 and substituting one angle for all the angles, because every angle is equal, then you get what? For example, 4 angle 1 equal to 360, therefore angle 1 equal to 90 degree, and now you can say all the angles are 90 degree. So the quadrilateral ABCD whose sides are equal and each angle is 90 degree, then it becomes a square. So this is a way you have to prove. It take us homework. So now coming to question number 6. In a parallelogram ABCD, diagonal AC bisect angle A, it is given. In a parallelogram, a diagonal AC bisect angle A, and you have to prove it bisect angle C also. Okay, AC bisect angle C, you have to show this diagonal AC bisect this angle C also. And then ABCD is a rhombus. So rhombus means how a parallelogram become rhombus. Parallelogram means, you know, opposite sides are equal. So rhombus means all sides equal. So you have to say all sides of ABCD equal, then that parallelogram becomes rhombus. Clear? So proof option 1, AC is the diagonal which bisects angle A. To show these two are equal angles, then only you can say AC bisect angle C also. For that you have to take these two triangles to prove congruent. In triangle ADC and triangle ABC, easily can say that these two angles are equal because they are opposite angle, no? These two angles, opposite angles of parallelogram. So ADC is equal to ABC because opposite angles of parallelogram, they are equal. And then already they have given the diagonal AC bisect angle A, so therefore we can have the first triangle CAD is equal to CAB. I'm right, as AC bisect angle A. So we can have this CAD is equal to CAB, and then AC is common for both triangle. AC equal to AC, that is common sign. Okay, by applying all this, you can say two angles on one side, two pair of angles and one pair of sides. So you can easily have that they are congruent. This implies triangle ADC congruent to triangle ABC by angle side congruence rule. So the side is not included here, so you can prove by other way also, but this is one way. By the given condition, we are taking this to prove that they are congruent. So after proving they are congruent triangle, easily we can say these two angles are equal. Okay, so what angle? ACD is equal to angle ACB. Okay, this is by CPCT, corresponding part of congruent triangle. After saying that the two angles are equal, then hence AC bisects angle C also. Okay, so easily you can say. And coming to the next part, option 2, that is ABCD is a rhombus. To say ABCD is a rhombus, so you have to take that this angle and that angle are equal because opposite angle. Angle BAD is equal to angle BCD. Because opposite, OPP means the short form opposite angles of parallelogram. So this is also short form of parallelogram. And then since they are equal, then we can say half of that are equal. So 1 by 2 of angle BAD is equal to 1 by 2 of BCD. Because they are equal angles, because ABCD is a parallelogram. So half of both angles are equal. This is nothing but, you see, half of BAD means, half of BAD means I am taking this one. What is that? Just we name any other, no need, you can take as DAC, angle DAC, that is equal to half of BCD means you can take this angle, okay, this angle, that is DCA, DCA. The half means you can take either this part or this part of BAD angle, and here you can take either this angle or this angle of BCD angle. So I am taking like this have that these two angles, for example, if I name it as 1 and 2, so angle 1 and 2 are equal because angle 1 is half of BAD and angle 2 is half of BCD. Okay, so because already we know angle A and C are bisect by the diagonal AC, so half of this one is 1 and half of this angle is 2, just less like that I am taking. Then now we have angle 1 and 2 are in the same triangle ADC. You see, in triangle ADC. So, in triangle ADC, angle 1 equal to angle 2. Okay, for our understanding, we can take like that. So, in a triangle, if two angles are equal, then it is isosceles triangle property. We can apply that. By applying that, we can say these two sides are equal. Sides opposite to equal angles. So here we can write AD equal to DC. The reason is sides opposite to equal angles. Clear? Of a triangle. Okay. So now we have proved these two sides are equal. Similarly, by taking this, the next half, suppose angle 3 and angle 4, suppose I am saying they are equal, and we can say these two sides are equal. Okay. Similarly, we can say, what? That angle, AB equal to BC. AB, side AB is equal to BC. Am I right? AD equal to DC and AB equal to BC. The same way you can say. And now, you know, in a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. But in a parallelogram, opposite sides are equal. This implies AB equal to AB equal to CD and BC is equal to AD. Now you see AD equal to DC and the same AD equal to BC. Okay, AB equal to BC and the same AB equal to CD. By seeing all these last four equations, hence AB equal to BC. You take first AB, where is it? Here. AB equal to BC. Yeah. See here, AB equal to BC and the BC equal to AD. Okay. Okay. And that AD equal to DC, you see. So now we got all the sides AB, BC, AD, DC. So all sides equal. Okay. Since all sides of parallelogram ABCD are equal, comma ABCD is a rhombus now. Right. In a parallelogram, if all the sides are equal, then it is a rhombus. That's what the proof. So now coming to question number 7, same exercise 8.1, more sums are there. So up to 8 sums we will see now. The next 4 sums we will see in the next class. Question number 7, it is given that ABCD is a rhombus. Okay. To prove diagonal AC bisect angle A as well as angle C, diagonal BD bisects angle B as well as angle D. Okay. For this, it is enough to say the first one. That means diagonal AC bisects angle A as well as angle C. So that's enough to say that the next diagonal BD bisect angle B as well as angle D. Okay. Any one you can show. But now I am trying to show that diagonal AC first. Okay. So, in the proof part, diagonals AC and BD of rhombus ABCD bisect at right angles. Diagonals AC and BD of rhombus ABCD, because ABCD is a rhombus, it is given. So in rhombus, you know that the diagonals bisect at right angles. Okay. This implies we can have AOB equal to BOC equal to COD equal to AOD. So the four angles around the point O, each angle is 90 degree because the diagonals bisect at right angle. Also, the side that means the diagonal segment, they bisect, no, they bisect each other. So you can have OA equal to OC and OB equal to OD. So this is what we can take from the given part. Okay. Now we have to say the diagonals bisect angle A as well as angle C. For that, you see, in this, that two triangles we can have, that AOB and you can take AOD. In that two triangle, easily you can say that AOB and AOD, if you say they are congruent, then these two angles are equal, you can say. Okay, you know how I am taking that? You see, in triangle AOB and triangle AOC. You see, why I am taking these two triangles? AOB, you can say that this OA is common. Okay, in that two, OA is common. OA equal to OA common side. Okay, common side, and OB equal to OD. Given, because diagonals bisect already we have taken OB equal to OD. So first AOB triangle OB, in AOD triangle OD, they are equal. OA is common, and these two angles are 90 degree. Now that you know, each angle is 90. So in these two triangle we can have that angle AOB is equal to angle AOD, because they are 90 degree. So two pair of angles and one pair of side, sorry, two pair of sides and one pair of angles. So you can easily say this one side. So include angle by RHS also we can say these two are congruent, because the two angles are 90 degree anyway, but the hypotenuse is not there. You should not say that RHS, because AD is the hypotenuse of this triangle and AB is the hypotenuse of the AOB triangle. So just we can say two pair of sides and one pair of angle. Through that we can say the two triangles are congruent. So triangle AOB is congruent to triangle AOC. Sorry, AOD only have to take. Sorry, here AOD. I just said AOD, but by mistake I have written AOC. So now triangle AOB and AOD, in these two triangles AOB and AOD, I have taken OA as common side and OB equal to OD. That is given here because the diagonal is bisect, and AOB equal to AOD, that two are 90 degree. So this, the two triangles are congruent by applying that rule. Two pair of sides. So yes, this is A. So you can have that included angle. So SAS. SAS rule. By SAS rule, we can say these two triangles are congruent. After proving that they are congruent, we can have these two angles. Angle 1, angle 2. So we can say, okay, you see, angle 1 from AOB triangle means angle 2 only. So for angle 2, you can write BAO. Okay, or OAB also you can write, is equal to OAD, CPCT. The reason, by CPCT, we can say angle 2 equal to angle 1. Angle 2 means I am writing OAB, and for angle 1 I am writing OAD. By CPCT we can say these two angles are equal. So now angle 1 and 2 are equal means, that means angle A is bisect by diagonal ACE. Easily we can say. Okay. Similarly, here if you take these two triangles, okay, then you can say this angle and this angle are what? Equal. Similarly, we have angle BCO is equal to angle DCO. By taking these two triangles as congruent, then easily you can say that two angles are equal. Okay. Hence, diagonal AC bisect angle A as well as angle C. So the diagonal AC bisect angle A as well as angle C, and moreover by applying the same properties and the proceedings, we can say similarly diagonal BD bisects angle B as well as angle T. easily we can say by applying the same concept. So now coming to question number 8. So given that ABCD is a rectangle and diagonal AC bisect angle A as well as angle C. So this is what given. So you consider ABCD as a rectangle and the diagonal AC bisect angle A as well as angle C. Okay. So angle A means these two angles equal and these two angles equal. So like that the diagonal AC bisects both angle A and C. Now we have to prove ABCD is a square. So ABCD is a square, we have to prove means you have to say all sides of this rectangle equal, then rectangle becomes square. Okay. And the second one, BD diagonal bisect angle B as well as angle D. So this is what we have to prove. So first you have to show ABCD as a square. So for that you have to take this ABCD rectangle. You know that the diagonal AC bisects angle A and angle C. So therefore, here BAD angle, BCD angle are 90 degree, that you know because rectangle. So BAD is equal to BCD. So that is equal to 90 degree. So angles of rectangle. Angles of rectangle is 90 degree, that you know. So we can take these two angles are 90 degree and they are equal. So half of this angle BAD is equal to half of angle BCD. So equal angles means if you multiply by half, if you make it half, then also they are equal. So half of BAD means we can take this angle. Half of BAD means we can take that. What? That is, we can say DAC. This implies DAC, and half of BCD means we can take this angle. Okay, that is DCA. Okay, because half of that means we can take either this one or this one, because the angle A is bisected by AC. Here also, angle C is bisected by the same diagonal AC. This is given in the question. So we can, the half means we can take this part here, and here we can take this part to make, to understand that the two angles are in the same triangle DCA. Okay. So in triangle DCA, two angles are equal. Two angles are equal. These two angles are equal in triangle DCA. So sides opposite to equal angles are equal. So this implies we can easily say AD equal to DC. AD equal to DC because sides opposite to equal angles, they are equal, that you know, isosceles triangle property. So these two sides are equal. But opposite sides of rectangle are equal, that we know. So easily we can have AD equal to BC and for BC we can write AB. So DC equal to AB. So in total we can say all sides are equal. AD equal to DC, the same AD equal to BC. So here AD equal to DC, this DC is equal to AB. That means what? All sides equal. So this implies AB equal to BC equal to CD equal to AD. This gives ABCD is a square. The rectangle becomes square because all sides equal. And now option 2, you see, you have to say diagonal BD bisect angle B as well as angle D. So you see, here I marked the angles 1, 2, 3, 4 and all. So here you take BC and CD equal. Since BC equal to CD, because we have proved that all sides equal. So proved, it is proved above. Okay, so we can easily say angle 1 equal to angle 2. Isosceles property, angles equal to, so angles opposite to equal sides, angles opposite to equal sides, we can take like that. So angle 1 equal to angle 2, and now angle 1 equal to angle 3, you know why? So angle 1 and 3 are alternate interior angles, and in rectangle, you know, if you take AB and CD as parallel and these B as transversal, then angle 1 and angle 3 are alternate interior angles. So we can write alternate angles as AB parallel to DC. AB parallel to DC means then we can have that alternate angles equal. You see now these two equations, angle 1 equal to 2 and angle 1 equal to 3. This implies angle 2 equal to angle 3. Angle 2 equal to angle 3. That means what? Angle B is bisected by this diagonal BD. So, diagonal BC bisect angle B. Okay. Similarly, we can say diagonal BC bisect angle D also. So this is what the proof. Thank you, children. Our worksheet is sent to you. So please you finish it and see the videos then and there. Thank you.